الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وحبيبه بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة فكشف الله به الغمة جاهد في سبيل الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين تركنا على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك فاللهم صلِّ وسلِّم وزد وبارك عليه وعلى أصحابه وأتباعه ومن سار على نهجه واختفى أثره إلى أن ترث ربنا الأرض ومن عليها اللهم إنا نشهدك ونشهد حملة عرشك وملائكتك وجميع خلقك بأنك أنت الله وحدك لا شريك لك وأن محمدا عبدك ورسولك يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد أيها الإخوة الكرام في شهر رمضان الفضيل كان كل واحد منا قد أحسن علاقته مع الله سبحانه وتعالى وقوى علاقته مع الله سبحانه وتعالى نصلي الصلاة في أوقاتها نذكر الله سبحانه وتعالى بأفضل الأذكار نصوم نخرج زكاتنا في رمضان نتقرب إلى الله سبحانه وتعالى بشتى العبادات دوما تجد المساجد ملأ في رمضان تجد الناس يتنافسون على العبادة يتنافسون على التقرب لله سبحانه وتعالى ندعو الله سبحانه وتعالى مخلصين من قلوبنا ولكن ماذا بعد رمضان ها هو شهر رمضان قد بقي منه القليل لم يبق منه إلا أياما معدودة فماذا نحن فاعلون بعد رمضان أيها الإخوة الكرام كثير من الناس وللأسف حينما ينتهي رمضان تنتهي علاقته مع الله سبحانه وتعالى تجده حينما كان يصلي قلما يصلي نحن لا نتكلم عن الصلاة في المسجد نتكلم عن الصلاة عامة تجده لا يصلي تجده لا يتقرب إلى الله سبحانه وتعالى بالنوافل تجده وقد ساءت علاقته مع الله سبحانه وتعالى ينظر إلى ماذا بعد رمضان وكأن رمضان كان شهرا لحبس الأنفاس ولكتم المعصية فيعوض بعد رمضان أيها الإخوة الكرام يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أحب الأعمال إلى الله أدومها وإن قل أن تكون دوما متصل بالله سبحانه وتعالى أن تكون دوما قريبا من الله سبحانه وتعالى أن تكون دوما حريصا على فعل الخير أن تكون دوما أو تتقرب إلى الله سبحانه وتعالى دوما بالنوافل أن يكون الإسلام أيها الإخوة الكرام هو منهج حياة، ولا يكون الإسلام والإيمان والتقرب إلى الله سبحانه وتعالى في رمضان فقط، ولكن الإسلام هو منهج حياة. فالله سبحانه وتعالى يريد منك الخير في رمضان وفي غيره. الله سبحانه وتعالى يريد منك أن تكون قريبا منه في رمضان وفي غيره، لا تكن مسلما رمضانيا فقط، ولكن كن مسلما ربانيا لله سبحانه وتعالى. فرب رمضان هو رب شعبان، هو رب شوال، هو رب الشهور كلها، هو الله سبحانه وتعالى. فكن مسلما ربانيا موحدا لله سبحانه وتعالى. بشر الحافي وهو من أحد الأئمة الأعلام قيل له: يا إمام، إن هناك أناسا يصلون ويتقربون ويطيعون الله سبحانه وتعالى في رمضان فقط. فقال: والله هم بئس القوم، هم بئس القوم، والله هم بئس القوم. الله سبحانه وتعالى أيها الإخوة الكرام يتفضل علينا ويعطينا في رمضان وفي غيره من المال ومن الولد. الله سبحانه وتعالى ينعم علينا في الشهور كلها، فلماذا نتقرب إلى الله سبحانه وتعالى في رمضان فقط؟ لماذا نكون قريبين من الله في رمضان فقط، رغم أن الله سبحانه وتعالى ينعم علينا في العام كله؟ الله سبحانه وتعالى كريم جواد في العام كله، فلماذا نكون فقط مع الله سبحانه وتعالى في هذا الشهر الكريم؟ النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول: انظر إلى سلعة الله سبحانه وتعالى. يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: ألا إن سلعة الله غالية، من يريد تلك السلعة، من يريد الجنة يجب أن يعمل للجنة. يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: ألا إن سلعة الله غالية، ألا إن سلعة الله الجنة. Dear brothers and sisters, Ramadan is almost over. Only few days left. Not even another Jum'ah. Only few days. And every and each one of us in Ramadan came closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Tried his best to obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Tried his best to come closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We pray our daily salah, even in masjid. We give our zakah. We fast. We try our best to pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Ramadan as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants. But the question that comes: what's after Ramadan? What's there after Ramadan? It's sorry, brother, to see the people after Ramadan disappear from the ibadat. Not even praying in the masjid. We are not talking about this. Even this is, we are losing a lot of reward. You are losing the sunnah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The people are not even performing the salah. There is some people, they commit the major sin during the whole year, and when Ramadan comes, they stop. As if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sees them only in Ramadan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching you through the whole year. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows what you're doing every single second. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is there at all time. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, dear brothers, doesn't want from you only a month of ibadah. Even this is the month that people should come closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not to pray, not to fast, not to give the zakah only in Ramadan. They come closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They engage more than the other days. But it doesn't mean they only pray in this month. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants a ibadah from you the whole year. Allah wants you to be closer to Him the whole year. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us, the best of the good deeds, the one they are continuously. Not a month of ibadah and then we disappear. Not a month closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and then when the month is done we think, what's the next step? How do we disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? No. Allah wants the ibadah from you the whole year. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us continuously ibadah is actually better than performing ibadah one time and leaving it at all after that. So continuously the ibadah, even with a little here and there, that's better to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, brothers, deserve from us more than this. Don't be only a Muslim for Ramadan. Be a Muslim who fears Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Ramadan and after Ramadan and even before Ramadan. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Lord of Ramadan, is the Lord of Shawwal, is the Lord of Sha'ban, is only one God. It's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's there the whole year. One of the great scholars, they told him, "Ya Imam, there are some people, they only pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Ramadan." He said, "Wallahi, they are the worst people. Because this is not what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from you." Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, dear brothers, He gives you the good through the whole year. Allah gives you health. Allah gives you wealth. Allah gives you children. Allah gives you everything in this life through the whole year. Why we are only obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in 1 month? Does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala deserve this from us? Only a month of ibadah? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who created you, who give you everything in this life, He deserve only a month of ibadah? No. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala deserve way more than what we are giving to Him. We have a lot of shorter in our ibadat. So brothers, the month of Ramadan is the month that gives you a push to continue the whole year. The Sahaba Ridwanullahi alayhim, they come closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Ramadan, yes. They ask after Ramadan, they keep closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they keep asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept this month from them. 6 months after Ramadan, praying, worshipping, engaging with the ta'at, and asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept from them the month of Ramadan. And the next few months before Ramadan, 5 months before Ramadan, they ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make them reach the next Ramadan. They see the chance. Not a chance to pray, not a chance to fast, a chance to come closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They used to close all their business, they sit there, they worship Allah. This is the month of Ramadan. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, كان أجود ما يكون في رمضان. The best, as in sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is always, he is in Ramadan. And the best in the last 10 days, which will almost be gone. They will be gone in few days. Brothers, are you happy with your relation with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? If you think that this month has brought you closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then continue up with this. If you think that the ibadat, then this month, haven't done any difference for you, then there is no difference for you in the next few months. Because this is the month of David. This is the month of obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But we have to continue after Ramadan. We have to keep this relation up with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at all time. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is telling us, the merchandise that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is offering to you is the Jannah. This is the merchandise, this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is offering you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not offering you money, He's not offering you house. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is offering you the Jannah, the best thing. So we need to work for the Jannah. This is the merchandise that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is offering to us. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at all times. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, اتَّقِ اللَّهَ حَيْثُمَا كُنْتْ. When you are advising the companion and telling him, اتَّقِ اللَّهَ حَيْثُمَا كُنْتْ وَأَتْبِعِ السَّيِّئَةَ الْحَسَنَةَ تَمْحُهَا وَخَالِقِ النَّاسَ بِخُلُقٍ حَسَنٍ. He's telling us to fear Allah wherever you are. Which time, it doesn't matter, wherever you are, what time it is, you fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. اتَّقِ اللَّهَ حَيْثُمَا كُنْتْ وَأَتْبِعِ السَّيِّئَةَ الْحَسَنَةَ تَمْحُهَا. Follow the sin that he committed, follow it with a good deed. Do it straight away. When you commit a sin, you repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and follow it with a good deed. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنَّ الْحَسَنَاتِ يُذْهِبْنَ السَّيِّئَاتِ. So follow the sin with a good deed and
treat the people with a good behavior. With a good behavior. Treat them with the manners that النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم taught you. الإمام ابن القيم told us what is the taqwa. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم told us to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's teaching us what is the taqwa. He's telling you the taqwa أن يجدك الله حيث أمرك وأن يفتقدك حيث نهاك. The real fearing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is the words of Imam Ibn al-Qayyim, he says the real fearing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sees you where He ever wants you to be. The places that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants you to be. This is the real taqwa. Engaging with the ibadat, with the salah, fasting, giving zakah, making du'as, being always with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In the places that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants you to be, this is the real taqwa. وَأَنْ يَفْتَقِدَكَ حَيْثُ نَهَاكَ. And he miss you. He doesn't see you in the places that he told you not to be. If you used to go to a place before Ramadan, this Ramadan should stop you from everything. Continue it. Continue being with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And there is some advices for myself and the brothers. The first one, for those who tested the taste of at-taqwa, the taste of being closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, don't lose it. Keep it up. Keep this relation with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by engaging yourself with more ibadat after Ramadan. Ramadan will be done, then we have 6 of Shawwal. 6 of Shawwal comes, then you have Mondays and Thursday, 13 and 14 and 15 from every Arabic month. There is so many ways of ibadat that you can keep it with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So keep this taste of the halawa, of the beauty of the iman. Keep this relation strong with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For the sisters who cover themselves in Ramadan, who wear hijab in Ramadan, keep this hijab after Ramadan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching you through the whole year. Keep this beauty in Ramadan and after Ramadan. Keep it up with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered you, commanded you to do it, so you do it through the whole year. Keep the hijab, keep the affah that you have with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, keep it there and don't lose it. For those young lads, young brothers, who found a good people in the masjid, that they prayed with them, that they had ate with them, that they had a good relation with them, keep this relation with those people. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us in the Quran, every single one will be an enemy to the others, except those fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Those who fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Jannah, they will be going together. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described that for us in Surah Az-Zumar, the end of Surah Az-Zumar. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us those people will be going in groups together. Those people who help you to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they will say to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Jannah, where is our friend? Where is the friend that he always used to tell us to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? He always used to push us for the ta'at, who's always used to remind us of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Keep this relation with those people. Those people, inshallah, will benefit you in the day of judgment when you are standing in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us in the Quran. Because the enemies, when somebody help you to commit the sin, you will be asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to step on him on the day of judgment because of the sin that he told you to do it. Oh Allah, this is the ayah in the Quran. Show us the people who misguide us, so we step on them. This is how it is. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, except those who fear him. Except those who have taqwa. Except those, their relation is only for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's only for the love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For those who left the sin, some people they really, and you've seen this a lot, some people they commit a major sin, major. Adultery, riba, a lot of things they do before Ramadan. And they only stop in Ramadan. No. No. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as we just mentioned, want this from you the whole year. wants you. Yes, the blessing is more, the reward is more in Ramadan, yes. But this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from you at all times, to leave the ma'asi, to leave the haram behind your back. This is not a way that we leave it before Ramadan and we leave it only Ramadan and then we start going back to the routine. Looking what we used to do before Ramadan and continue doing it. No, keep it up, keep the relation up with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As well, the brothers who are being killed all over the place in Syria and all over the countries. Those brothers have a right on you. Those brothers, at least Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us, if you don't care about the Muslims, you're not one of them. You don't have the real iman. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us to care about our Muslims at all times. The brothers have been killing all over the place. Do not at least forget them from your du'as. At least this is the least you can do for them. This is the least we can offer them. This is the least at the main time we can do for them. Those brothers, never forget them from your du'as. Never forget that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala releases the ghumma that they're going through. Never ask that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect them from al-zalimeen. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. بسم الله وصلي وسلم على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين جاء بالحق بشيرا ونذيرا وداعيا إلى الله بإذنه وسراجا منيرا اللهم صلي وسلم وزد وبارك عليه وعلى أصحابه وأتباعه ومن سار على نهجه واختفى أثره إلى أن ترك ربنا الأرض ومن عليها إن شاء الله. Dear brothers, follow up with the website. We will announce inshallah for the Eid, and the Eid will be inshallah in the masjid here. We will have two salah of Eid inshallah in this masjid. The timing of the salah and the day, of course, inshallah, it will be announced. We will be announcing it in Taraweeh, as we have the Taraweeh and Tahajjud every day. But as well, inshallah, you will be seeing it inshallah in the website. So follow it in the website or even call the masjid inshallah. You will know inshallah what day and what times inshallah. We will be having two salah at Taraweeh. As well, make sure inshallah you give your zakat al-fitr before Ramadan, before Salat al-Eid. Because if you pray Eid, then you give it after that, it will count as a sadaqah. It won't count as zakatul fitr. So you have to give your zakatul fitr before Salat al-Eid, inshallah. Make sure you give it before Salat al-Eid. And it's €7 for the person. The child, like the 20, like the 30, like the 40, like the 60, it's one currency. And if you're living here, you have to give it for the price of here. So it's €7 for the person. And make sure, inshallah, to give it before Salat al-Eid. جزاكم الله خيرا. اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك يا مولانا قريب سميع مجيب الدعوات. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا وكفر عنا سيئاتنا وتوفنا مع الأبرار. اللهم إنك عفو تحب العفو فاعف عنا. اللهم إنك عفو تحب العفو فاعف عنا. اللهم إنك عفو تحب العفو فاعف عنا. اللهم تقبل منا الصيام والقيام وصالح الأعمال. اللهم إنا نسألك يا رب قبل الموت توبة وعند الموت شهادة وبعد الموت جنة ونعيمة. اللهم اغفر لنا تقصيرنا يا رب العالمين. اللهم أعنا على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك. اللهم يا رب انصر إخواننا المستضعفين في مشارق الأرض ومغاربها. اللهم كن لهم معينا وناصرا. اللهم أيدهم بمدد من عندك وبجند من جندك. اللهم إنا نسألك يا رب أن تهلك الظالمين. اللهم عليك بالظالمين. اللهم عليك بالظالمين. اللهم إنهم لا يعجزونك. اللهم إنهم لا يعجزونك. اللهم أرنا فيهم عجائب تدميرك وقدرتك يا رب العالمين. اللهم أهلكهم يا رب العالمين. اللهم أهلك الظالمين بالظالمين وأخرجنا من بينهم سالمين. عباد الله, إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله العظيم يذكركم واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم واستغفروه من ذنوبكم يغفر لكم وأتوب إليه.